Pankaj, The whole event is actually to hear the experience of these environments over here.
Inside.
Especially sure. So we very capacity role is there. But what is your story?
I was thinking of partying only.
But we are very interested in knowing and how did you make it happen and so what is the one thing?
For party only.
No, why is doing the event, not this event. Oh, this jives with what Dr. Satish said just now. By running PMM, you already know what your typing is going to be against you. In your status, you have a guy, 30 people, and you have a guy, 40 people. So, even then, you are thinking of the party.
I'm
party like this to celebrate your success. You have to do it.
So we'll put the other way. So how long the training took my party one day?
2006.
You thought of the event and you need to love it. It's you want to.
For me, it's tougher because it's one day. It's back to back to back, you don't have time to think. That's why I've done 20 Ironmans and only one.
Make sense. Any other questions? Come on,
please go ahead.
What
are
the
places you have done?
Mona. And it's favorite because it was a complete nightmare of a day. What I had planned, what I had trained for, it was completely opposite. Everything that could go wrong went wrong that day.
Oh.
So that's why it's my favorite race.
Okay.
So you'll have to learn to adapt in 1 minute.
So as you have done this time, you will be automatically called for next time or?
No.
Once a lifetime.
Yeah.
But if you want
no,
to do that?
No guaranteed.
Do you want for next one?
No, it's too expensive. No chance.
Very expensive.
Very expensive.
Yeah,
why? Expensive
just
to get
there.
Apart from expense,
or you're talking about
financial expense?
Yeah.
So you could do every Ironman in that one race, so I'll save the money.
So, is it the timing that you require to get into that race, or what is it?
Yeah, there's only two ways you can get in, right? You have to be very fast in your age group, win the age group, or you have to do 12 Ironmans, which 12 times 3 lakhs, you know.
Simplest.
But again, there's 50-60 people in that category as well. I think only 50 or 100 slots, I'm not sure. So that may get moved again. So you either become very fast or very rich. Choice is yours.
There's no Kona 70.3?
The world championship for 70.3 is rotating. So this year it was in US, next year it's in South Africa. It switches over. There is a Hawaii 70.3, just do it twice instead of just Kona.
Or you can simply fly to Kona. And just do it. I say I did Olympic distance. So are we getting to look at the Kona medal today?
Yeah.
Oh!
सजेशन है कि इसको टच कर लो. बहुत जने को टच करने को नहीं मिलेगा, मैं बता रहा हूँ. बट
आई थिंक गुड सेव दिया है. वाओ,
पार्टी
जॉन का तो अरे दादा, गाइस, यू आर लाइक 5-10 feet अवे फ्रॉम दिस कोना मेडल. आई एम टेलिंग यू, दिस इज टच इट बट विद केयर. ओके, दिस इज वेरी ऑसम.
Salute.
So what is left now after achieving so much?
40.
20.
There's 5 more Ironmans left. 5 more. Let's
go
25.
You're
talking
25 by the end of
2020.
2020.
I wonder that you once said that your fastest was 11:03.
Yeah.
2013. And you said you had a partner then. Yeah, I had a training partner. She was at Kona this year.
Okay.
Don't ask her
time to.
No, but you were, I saw her on the run and she was on the way back and I was just struggling and starting my walk.
He's worried about that. And rest of us, when we are finishing our cycle,
the winner is being
announced. He was the same as Kona, right?
Yeah.
The next winner had already finished. And they were saying Daniela Rice is now 3 kilometers away from the finish line.
Well, fine.
Get to see
her. That's pretty awesome. But you, that 11:03 was when you ran in the US or?
Yeah. 2013.
So how did you come to know of Ironman?
Yeah. I was in a hot tub with a whole bunch of triathletes who were talking about Ironman, and I had no clue. And they had just come back from Kona. They were discussing who won what were their times. So I asked them. And I mean, I have a fairly decent swimming background, and I had run 2 or 3 marathons by then. So they said it's very easy for you. The swim is just uphill. You have run marathons. Cycling is the easiest. They didn't stop there. They said, oh, there's a race in Arizona. It used to be in April. It's moving till November now. It opens this week. You should sign up. So I didn't, you know, then I'm calling my friend, really, $600 to sign up?
That time also 600?
Yeah. Okay. It's like 500 plus.
Which year was this?
2008.
Right?
There were only 10 races in the world. In the US, there are 5 races. Now I think US has 15, but I didn't have a bike when I signed up. Like, okay, now I'm signed up. My friends were like, how about the cycle now? Wow, by the way, another $2,000 I didn't have. Malaysia is tough. Wisconsin, which is my fastest, is one of the toughest ones. Brazil is challenging. I mean, there's no such thing as an easy Ironman, because the course may be somewhat easy, but you can't control the weather, you can't control the swim. Whatever luck you get that day, you have to deal with it.
Somebody told me that out of the different categories of Ironman, Olympic distance is equally distributed between run, swim and cycle. And the distance increases, it is more inclined towards cycling. Is it true? Fitness about...
I think that discussion happened on the group this last time.
That's a very controversial
topic,
I'm telling you.
No, I'm just asking.
A very good dear friend of mine has an answer. I will make me meet him.
He
will tell you in great detail what he thinks.
Difference between categories is professional and amateur. Like you are in
amateur
now?
Yeah, amateur. Professionals are competing for prize money. You have to be again really, really fast, or you have to get a professional license from your country. So you know people in the Indian Triathlon Association, and they give you a professional license, so you're eligible to compete as a professional.
Suppose you are in a amateur, but you have a better timing than Patrick Lamley or whatever, then you will get prize, no? No?
Yes,
two separate categories.
You have to
offer. Sign up as a professional, you can only raise as a professional.
Then only you will get prize. Amateurs don't have a prize then.
There's no cash.
Yeah.
It's all Facebook prize. How many likes?
So, how difficult is it to see practice in India? Vis-a-vis practicing in the US. I believe you talk about practicing in India with the current conditions of road and whatever being much more difficult than practicing outside. Any challenges which you face in India as against?
So obviously swimming, we all know, lack of good swimming pools. In open water is pretty much non-existent, which anywhere in the US at least is quite achievable and good. Road conditions, I don't think I need to specify about that. Depends on which city you live. Again, I was fortunate that my Ironman journey started in Boulder.
Okay.
So you could cycle hundreds of miles without seeing people, only cyclists. And they have a cycling track. But I moved to Baltimore and it was a completely different story. So there are challenges everywhere you go. Unfortunately, pollution is the issue here, which does not exist. Anywhere else in the world, you can go for a run or cycle in middle afternoon. We don't have that luxury. But you can make do. I mean, there's a lot of professionals now who are training indoors. Completely indoor on the trainers or on the rollers. So if you want to do it, I think you can do it.
So, I've been following you since long. So, I'll make aware people about the Costco has done two, as I am aware, two Ironman in injuries. One is with knee injury and one is within training. So how would you suggest us that during the training, for example, I have been preparing since eight months, and at the before event or 2 months or 1 month I face injury. So I should attempt or not, or how did you manage or something?
So it depends what your injury is, how serious it is. Again, the dengue story is different. Not many people know my platelets have stabilized. You realistically have dengue, you should not be attempting an Ironman. my ACL, I did 2 months of very good rehab. So even my orthopedic said, if you're ready, you should go. You have to understand that for most of you, it's just a passion. So don't do something which will cause injury for a very long time. If you're in that situation, then there's other races. In 2015, I crashed in Malaysia. That is the reason why I went last year, because that last year was supposed to be the last time they were going to have the full. So in 2015, the monkey zone, I was coming down. And I'm not sure if I hit a pebble or my bike slipped. I fell down. I fractured 2 ribs and my wrist. And I lost my gearing. So this was the first loop for 12 kilometers. So I made it till 90 on a single speed, but my wrist had gone this big. So that's when I said, you know, it's my life at the end of the day, because you have to do the same loop again. So that time I decided, you know what, I'll come back another day. So you can use that as an example. If you're really injured, then there's other races, there's more things you can do for it to push yourself.
Do we get to read your book or something in time to come?
Yeah. I mean, as soon as Amit Sheikh has time to write it, I'm writing it. I just need someone to add a lot more. Hopefully next year it will be published.
Co-author? He's a co-author for that book?
No. I was just saying.
Yes, why is he the co-author?
My wife is writing, I'm just reading it.
No, Amit said your name, no? That's Amit.
After 11.
So, Rajesh, I think you asked how much time. I think you know my philosophy of training. Give yourself enough time, there's no rush. Because the training is intense, as you know. Injuries can come, but life comes in the way as well. Family events, good events, bad events, and every single day you miss in training, you will remember that on Facebook. So give yourself a good 6 to 9 months. Then properly, you know, one big thing that I tell you, to every, and you know you have practiced with me, is that whatever you do, practice how to change a puncture at least 10 times on each
beat.
Because I know people who have lost their races because they could not fix a puncture. I have two in Malaysia. And you have to smile and get through it. But it can cost you. And that's the most basic thing you should learn. How to put your chain back on if it falls. And how to fix it.
One question.
Yeah.
Everybody here over posts how much mileages they are doing every week or month. What is your mileages
a week or month? I don't know. In terms of
swim, bike and run. Like how much, over a month, how much do you
swim, how much do you bike or run?
Like on average.
Last 3 years, I don't think I've done half as much as I used to. And mostly because I'm also, I just started my own business, so it takes up a lot of my time as well. I've had some health issues as well, which have crept up. So I have asthma. Obviously with the Indian weather, it affects a lot more. So my mileage is, even for Ultraman, the longest ride I did was Ironman Malaysia, 180 kilometers. After that, I didn't ride on the road at all. So my mileage is, again, as a coaching philosophy also, I believe in low mileage, but good quality training. So on average, in a week, I swim about 10 kilometers. I cycle 2 to 3 1-hour rides and one long ride, 6 to 7 hours. And then running, I have a big group which runs. So 3 hours is guaranteed, plus minus a break. Four and a half hours.
Sir, I have never seen you on biking on road, so where do you bike?
Because I always cover whole Pune and highways.
He waits outside your house all the time.
Yeah, he's a stalker.
So you don't follow him on Instagram?
Everywhere I follow him.
I mean, it's sad, but you know what happened last.